Recently, a new documentary came out. It's called The Seaspiracy. And really, it's talking about fisheries, overfishing, pollution, ghost nets. A lot. Also targeting things like fish farms and where the hell all this fish actually comes from. So really something I've been looking forward for a long time and a topic that has been left out of media for a fair bit and really has been ignored too much. Now, I'm not a rocket scientist, but then really on a topic like this, you might not want to have a rocket scientist talking about it. So I am a marine biologist and I wanted to add a few things to that movie. First of all, I think it was really well done, rather emotional in many levels, but it brings a couple of things pretty much down to the point. And a few things are somewhat oversimplified, which is fair enough because you want to reach a broad audience, but certain things just need to be said. So one of the main features for me that was kind of left out is the way that fish farms work. Now, everywhere in the world, doesn't matter if you're talking about land or water, you always have food chains. So by the very nature of the fish we like to eat, we love to eat predators. So we are really targeting the big hunters that we want to catch. So for nets, that means that we need, in theory, a wide mesh. In reality, we have fine mesh, so we get everything. But for the fish that we farm, we are really going for the big ones. Now, big fish, just like any other, will taste like what it is eating. So you have to feed it fish. Obviously, there's also fish that taste like chicken, but those are actually the ones that get fed ground up chicken. So that aside, if you want a fish that tastes like fish and is the one that you can sell for a lot of money, you need to feed it fish. So bottom line is, for every fish farm out there, there is some fishing boats right next to it, and usually it's big industrial fishing trawlers that will catch the food for the farmed fish. So really all you're doing in a fish farm is converting one fish to another with a horribly bad exchange rate. So I know this is absolutely not an accurate number, but more or less 1 to 10. So for every kilogram of fish you grow out in the farm, you have to invest 10 kilograms of food into that fish. Now, if we're talking about Brancin, like in Croatia, yes, that actually does check out and you might be feeding it sardines. If we're talking about top predators, like tuna that cannot be farmed, by the way, all tuna is always wild catch and it's just getting fed in a cage before they hunt it and kill it. But the higher the predator, the higher grade the food has to be. All right, now that being said, along with the same exchange rate, a lot of other things accumulate. So we have been starting in the Seaspiracy movie with the issue of ocean plastic. Now, plastic as such is not a biggie, in theory. The reality is it looks like shite. And that's really one of the main reasons why people do care about the plastic altogether. In reality, well, the touristy spots do get a cleanup every now and then, and that's why the beaches do look clean in certain areas. Absolute fact also is that if it wasn't for somebody cleaning up, I'd say 99% of all beaches around the globe would look the same. They would be covered in plastic. Now, plastic does break down in the sun though, and sun and salt water combined are always a horrible combination for any material. Plastic is not an exception, it's also true for steel, for anything, really. So once it breaks down, you have smaller and smaller particles, which is pleasing for the eye because it's not so visible anymore, but it is absolutely not pleasing when it comes to the logistics of it. Because plastic, again, it's still plastic, so it is made of oil, so, well, it's of no use for any body that is actually eating it. Well, there's a few bacteria that can digest it by now, but I'll leave that aside because they are really far away from being efficient in digesting. Anyways, so you got your plastic, it does break down smaller and smaller pieces, but the plastic that we use every day, doesn't matter if you're talking about fishing nets or cables or anything else, it is not just straightforward plastic. We do add colors, we do add softeners, we do add all sorts of different chemicals. And those chemicals are not good for us. So some might be toxic, some might be blending in and acting like hormones on our body. So bottom line is, they are an issue for our health. So since they are combined with the plastic anyways, and really microplastic is kind of acting like a magnet, so it's kind of sucking all those toxins close to it. And then this stuff gets eaten by tiny animals. So we are talking about ingestion of, for example, tiny little plankton animals that would eat or would feed on generally phytoplankton, so it's plant plankton, and that then accumulates in their body. So we're starting at the very, very bottom of the food chain. Now, those tiny crabs or whatever they might be, ingest all that microplastics and all the toxins accumulate. So because it keeps eating all its life, in this tiny little crab, at some point you will end up with, again, more or less 10 times the amount of all these toxins that you would have had in the ocean beforehand. Now, this is not where it starts. Actually, that's where it only gets interesting. Because every toxin, doesn't matter if we're talking about quicksilver, any heavy metal, or all this stuff that's in the plastic, always the same story. So on land, what we have is, for example, in the soil, you have heavy metals. All right, grass takes them out of the soil, a cow eats the grass, we eat the cow. Three steps in the food chain. So bottom line is, when we eat it, we accumulate in our body about 1,000 times more of all these heavy metals than we used to have in the soil beforehand. So far, so good. Underwater, food chains are a lot longer. So you have the heavy metals or the toxins from the plastic, whatever it is you want to talk about, you have that in the water, gets taken up by plankton, gets eaten up by some tiny fish. The tiny little ones that you see floating around everywhere. Gets eaten by sardine, gets eaten by a orada beberantin, by a grouper, whatever. Gets eaten by a tuna, and that gets eaten by us. And all of a sudden, just like that, you got six zeros instead of three. So that again means that in us, we have 1 million times the amount of all this toxic stuff. So it is a serious health issue for us. And that's something that was left out in the Seaspiracy. They did talk about all the antifungicides, all the crap that we have to feed these fish so they can actually survive. Antibiotics, fungicides. Plus, they did talk about all the pollution that a fish farm does create in a very, well, usually enclosed space, because generally speaking, they are tied up in bays. But on top of that, also all the crap is accumulating in the fish that we eat. And that, by the way, is also true for all the wild catch. And that actually reaches a point where, for example, salmon, which is also rather high up on the food chain, if you catch it and you kill it, it's fine. If you would find a salmon as it dies and you pick it up a second later, it would be considered toxic waste. No, nothing changed in between. The salmon is still the same. It still has the exact same stuff in its body, in its bloodstream, in the meat. But yet, because you did not actively commit the act of killing it and therefore hunting it and therefore creating food, you just collected something, it is considered toxic waste. So that's the reality we're living in, and that's the stuff we're actually eating. Yeah. So, but the starting point really was all the plastic in the ocean, which is a shit show, in one word. And yes, it does get more. We all heard about the five jars by now. I mean, if you're watching this video, chances are that you did think about this whole scenario before. Five jars in the world's oceans, so two Pacific, two Atlantic, one in the Indian Ocean. By now, also, the Mediterranean is also actually considered an entire gyre. So the entire Mediterranean Sea, just because of the high concentration of plastics in it, it's considered a plastic gyre. And that's something we single-handedly messed up. So, one other thing that was absolutely left out, and that was something I really expected to be in this Seaspiracy documentary, was the fact that we are running out of fish. I know the number 2048 was mentioned, and that's the prediction of when we run out of fish, but also something that was kind of in the lower ranks of the media in a couple of years ago was the fact that basically we have been faking our catch numbers for decades. So what really came out, and that was in the early 2000s, is, well, we are building more and more fishing boats. They are getting bigger and bigger and bigger. They are getting more and more efficient. So in reality, you would expect that every year, humanity as a whole catches more and more fish. False. The fact is that every year we have been catching less and less, even though the machinery behind it was getting better and better and more efficient. So really what happened is that the CEOs and the big bosses, they were scared to say that they caught less than their guy before them than they did in previous years, because simply the way our economics work is that you have to grow and grow and grow. And it's just not happening. We are talking about a very limited source. We are talking about an ocean, which is fair enough huge, but life is limited. So they have been faking the numbers to basically look as if they were growing and growing and growing, which in reality they were not. And only a couple of years later, that was exposed. And truth is, we have been catching less and less for a couple of years now, even though fishing pressure was constantly increased and was getting more and more, and the boats were getting bigger and more efficient. So this is the reality we're living in. And when it comes to catching sustainably, that's where the real shit show begins. So fact is, yes, sustainable fishing would be possible, but nowhere near the amounts that we are catching. You can talk to any farmer, they will tell you, yes, you can have sustainable grown cow and you will give them good life and they will enjoy their life, and eventually you will kill them and eat them. In the water, yes, you could do the same thing. You could have massive big marine protected areas and catch small amounts around. But at this point, we are way past that point because we just simply want too much fish. And it is a limited resource and we are on a very limited planet. It is big as hell. Well, bigger than that, but it is limited. So let's face it, if we want to have anything in a sustainable way, we have to limit the amount of that harvesting, well, interest that we are creating everywhere. And that's really it. So we're talking about infinite growth on a very finite planet. And that's just not working out ever. So it was just a few thoughts about my point of view about the whole Seaspiracy. If you haven't seen it yet, I really highly recommend that you have a look at it. There is a lot more information around the topic. Just read deeper into it. MSC actually is a great resource for information. And yes, I am talking about the label. And no, the label is no good at all. It was a great idea when it was started, but since then it has degraded to basically the best label money can buy. So in reality, it's worth nothing. And yeah, but they are still an NGO, they are still transparent about all the information that is on the website. The trouble is you have to dig extremely deep, and you will lose days and weeks of your life digging through the information until you get to the bottom of it. And the bottom is, for example, a fishery that kills less than 20 dolphins for one catch is considered sustainable and can get certified. And a fishery that's absolutely not sustainable, but yet promises to try be sustainable within 5 years, might just end up getting the label if they pay for it. And that's just not what I as a consumer would expect if I'm buying a certified product. So that's not what it should be. Just my thoughts. Anyways, we have a lot more information on many of these topics, including plastics, on this channel. So make sure to have a look around if you are interested in it. If you have seen the movie already, please leave us a comment. Let me know what you think about it. And we will be bringing a lot more on, not the Seaspiracy anymore, but definitely on the topics, simply because we do care. We are working on it. We are researching all this stuff and we want to tell you the truth about it. So stay safe, keep calm, and try to stay away from the fishing industry. All the best. Bye.